we observed a massive shift to digital real-time media during the pandemic. Video calls, online conferences, or virtual job interviews, for example, offered a great solution to the remote working problem. Today, it is hard to find a business where real-time media does not play a significant role. Most of the cases, when video, audio, or data is sent through the web, rely on WebRTC, the web real-time communication that skyrocketed in the past few years. This is an open-source project supported by Google, Apple, and Microsoft, with the aim to let web developers to build powerful voice and video communication solutions. Okay, but how does this work in practice? Let's assume that you would like to call your friend on the web, Skype or Messenger, for example. First, to be able to find your friend anywhere on the world, you both must be registered in an application server that will forward your call request to the other side. Then, you need a SAN server to figure out your public IP address if you are behind a firewall. This public address is then used to connect you with your friend. Besides, it can also happen that media streams are not allowed to travel directly between the two devices, so you also need a TURN server that helps to bypass these media firewalls. Last but not least, it's pretty much possible that later on you would like to invite others to the call, to have a video conference, or to manipulate the media, do face recognition or object detection, for which you will need a media server. Now, from a provider's point of view, the problem is that usually these devices do not scale well with the number of connected clients. Or if you rely on solutions of hyperscale cloud providers, then extra traffic comes with extra cost. What is worse, in some cases, you just simply cannot let the traffic leave your data center. Think about businesses or organizations with strict privacy restrictions, such as players from the finance sector, healthcare, governments, or companies dealing with intellectual properties. Operating these servers in a self-hosted Kubernetes cluster doesn't go easy, and you will quickly find yourself on Stack Overflow. The very crucial question is how to receive the UDP-based RTP media and how to interact with it. The solution is called Stunner, a Kubernetes ingress gateway for WebRTC that is open source and builds on the Python library. The goal of Stunner is to make WebRTC a first-class citizen in the cloud, enabling all its potential that is already available for HTTP-based workload. Stunner consists of a STUN and TURN server located at the edge of the cluster and publishing a single IP and port through which WebRTC applications can be accessed. This, by the way, gives more security than running all services on node ports. Stunner can be configured on the fly with the Stunner Gateway operator, and ongoing sessions can be monitored as it streams data into the metrics API. Since Stunner brings media into the cluster, now WebRTC developers can focus on writing applications rather than being network engineers.